Welcome back to Tip Top Trading, where everyone seems a bit flustered.
And we really need the best biscuits there are.
Yes, and I've made sure there's tea and coffee.
And the carpets?
Huh?
Have they been cleaned?
Don't panic, Paul. All taken care of.
You see, the big boss from America, Mr. Socrates, is in town, and everything must be just right. What's he like, Anna?
Well, so far, he seems okay. A bit bossy, quite short, and a bit smelly.
Well, he did just fly in from the States. But you booked him into a good hotel, so hopefully he's had a chance to clean up.
I hope so. Oh, I had better get that. Hello? Hello, Mr. Socrates. Did you sleep well? Oh, I see. I don't know. Tom said it was 5-star. Well, okay, good. Oh, he's hung up.
Everything okay, Anna? You look a bit pale.
It was Mr. Socrates. He's not happy.
Golly gosh, oh dear. What's the matter?
It's his hotel room. He doesn't like it. The bed's too soft, too small, and it's a single room, not a twin room.
Oh yes, he likes to have two beds in the room for some reason.
But Tom said he only likes a single bed in the room.
Really? Oh no, he insists on a twin. Something to do with business partners, he says. Anything else?
Yes, he says he wanted freshly squeezed orange juice for breakfast. Not the stuff out of a carton.
Anything else? A view of Mount Everest, perhaps?
Yes, thank you, Denise. Well, we really must sort this out. We can't afford to upset Mr. Socrates. Now, Anna, you chose this hotel. I really think you need to sort out this mess.
It was Tom's suggestion.
Just sort it quickly. Oh, golly gosh, golly gosh.
Uh-oh, Anna. Time to do some complaining. What are you going to say?
Oh, I don't know. I'm not very good at complaining.
Well, Anna, keep your cool and politely tell the hotel why you're not happy. You could say, I'm very disappointed with your service. The standard of service is not good enough. The room I booked did not meet my expectations. Good luck, Anna.
Okay, here goes.
Hello, Royal Imperial Hotel.
Hello, I want to complain.
Really? About what exactly?
Your hotel. Well, I mean, a room I booked for my boss. Room 101. I'm very disappointed with your service.
And why is that then?
Well, the room isn't like the one I booked. It's just not good enough.
Let's have a look at that booking. Well, your boss got a bed and a breakfast too. A continental breakfast, in fact.
But the room just didn't meet his expectations. Hello?
Give me the phone, Anna. I'll deal with this. Now, hello, Miss...
Miss Fit?
Miss Fit? This is the officer's... I mean the manager here. This isn't good enough. My colleague has made it quite clear that the room did not meet our requirements, and I would like you to resolve this matter as quickly as possible, or I will have to cancel our reservation.
Sadly, we have no other twin rooms available, and anyway...
All right. I'd like to speak to your manager, please. Really?
Good old Denise. I can tell she's done this before. But will talking to the manager really sort things out? Let's remind ourselves of some of the phrases you can use when you need to complain.
I'm very disappointed with your service. The standard of service is not good enough. The room I booked did not meet my expectations.
And to get things sorted, you could say...
I would like this matter resolved as quickly as possible.
Or...
I would like to cancel my reservation and get a full refund.
Let's see if Denise has sorted things out.
So, have you managed to sort out Mr. Socrates?
Oh, yes. Anna's got him a new room.
Thanks, Anna. I'll let him know. And what about the orange juice?
Freshly squeezed every morning.
Oh, golly gosh. That reminds me, we need some here in the office. He's going to be here any minute, and he says he's got some important news for us.
Hello again. It's the big day and Mr. Socrates is about to arrive at the offices of Tip Top Trading to talk officially to the team. What's he going to say? And more importantly, will he get his freshly squeezed orange juice?
Quickly, everybody, he's coming out of the lift with Paul.
Anna, quickly, get a glass of orange juice ready.
And if we come through this door here, we get to the office. And, morning everyone. I'm sure we've all met Mr. Socrates on the day of the, fire. But today, everything is a bit calmer and, well, he's here to say hello.
Hi.
Biscuit, Mr. Socrates?
Biscuit? You mean a goddamn cookie. Thanks.
Mr. Socrates, I'm Anna. Would you like some orange juice, freshly squeezed?
You betcha, as long as it's made from Florida oranges. Hey, Anna, ain't you the girl that booked my hotel room?
Yes. Sorry about the bed, and...
Hey, you got me a new room. It was great. You did a good job there. Well done.
Oh, thanks.
Hello, it's Tom. I recommended the hotel. It was,
Tom, everyone. Shall we gather round and hear what Mr. Socrates has to say? Please.
Hey, what's your name?
Paul.
Yeah, you. Don't you think I should be sitting in the big chair?
Sorry. Yes, of course. There you go.
Now, tip-top trading. I gotta give it to you straight. Things ain't looking good. In fact, the outlook is gloomy. The global recession has led to a meltdown in the plastic fruit sector. And I've got to announce a profit warning. We just ain't selling enough of these bananas, oranges, and lemons to make any money.
There's a bit of an economic squeeze on lemons.
What?
Oh dear, I'm not sure what he's talking about, but it sounds bad.
It is, Anna. He's delivering some bad news without hiding the truth. That's why he said, I've got to give it to you straight. He said, the outlook is gloomy, which means the future doesn't look good. And he mentioned a profit warning, which means company profits are probably going to go down.
Crikey, that is bad. What does it mean?
Just keep listening for now.
So, this calls for action. I'm going to have to...
Oh no, not me, Mr. Socrates. I've been a loyal employee. I couldn't face being unemployed.
Tom, calm down.
I'm not talking about redundancies yet.
Gosh, well, that calls for another biscuit.
My plan is we're going into Europe.
You mean we're moving to Europe?
No, Anna. I think he means we're going to sell plastic fruit to the European market.
Oh, right. Oh, great. Mr. Socrates, I've lots of experience with Europe. I had a holiday in Spain once, twice, actually.
Well, we'll have to make sure our phones can make international calls.
I think you're going to need some help with this, so I'm bringing in my best marketing executive, Rachel. What she doesn't know about selling to Europe, you don't want to know. She'll be here in a few weeks' time.
Do you know if she prefers tea or coffee? Or orange juice, perhaps.
Look, Diana.
Denise.
Like Dennis, right? She'll want the best tea, coffee, the best team. I'll expect improved results and profits. If not, your necks will be on the line. Especially yours, Paul.
Oh, chop, we'd better get back to work.
Mm-hmm. scary.
Your necks will be on the line. He means their jobs will be at risk if things don't improve. It's a worrying time for tip-top trading. Let's remind ourselves of the phrases Mr. Socrates used to deliver bad news.
I've got to give it to you straight. The outlook is gloomy. I've got to announce a profit warning.
Let's hope this new marketing strategy for Europe's going to work. How are you feeling, Anna?
A little nervous, but I'm going to try my best to make sure this new strategy works.
That's the spirit, Anna.
Right, everyone. I think we need to take Mr. Socrates down to the Rose and Crown after work for a pint or two and show him some true English hospitality. How about it?
I don't drink.
Oh, well, perhaps some lemonade?
Oh, dear. This should be interesting. Until next time, bye! Hello again. Tip-top Trading's big boss, Mr. Socrates, has announced a new strategy to sell plastic fruit to Europe and hopefully keep the company afloat. But before the real work begins, it's time for him to enjoy some good English hospitality at the pub, courtesy of the team from the London office. Let's join them now.
Well, welcome to the Rose and Crown. It is small, not like one of those bars you get in your country. Can I get you a pint, Mr. Socrates?
A what?
A pint. A pint of beer. It's really nice here, if you like it.
I don't drink. Just an orange juice, freshly squeezed.
Oh, go on, Mr. Socrates. One pint won't hurt. You've got to have a pint of beer when you come to a pub.
Ugh, very well. I'll try one. It had better be good.
You'll love it. Right, I'll get it. 3 pints of your best beer, please, Mr. Landlord. Denise, are you okay getting your own? I'm a bit short of cash.
Oh, right. Mr. Socrates, Anna said she would be along soon. She had some work to finish. She's such a hard worker.
Good to hear. She seems like a smart cookie. Now let's try this beer. Not bad. A little warm, but tasty.
Oh, you drank that quickly. Would you like another one?
Sure.
Hi, everyone. Sorry I'm late.
Hi, Anna. Look, Mr. Socrates is enjoying our English beer. I think it's going to his head.
Anna, our best worker. Get Anna a drink.
Yes, Mr. Socrates. Of course, Mr. Socrates.
Anna, come over here. Let's talk.
All right. What about...
There you go, Anna. I got you some crisps, too. So, what are we talking about?
Nothing. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Oh, right. Yeah, bye-bye. I'll go and talk to Paul and Denise. I'll just be over here.
What a loser. I can tell he's all talk and no action.
Well, Tom's a good worker, really, and...
And as for Paul, God, what a manager. Always eating cookies. You know, he was fired from his last job because...
Anna, I think he's getting a bit too personal. That beer's making him say things he shouldn't.
I know. What should I say?
Try saying it's not appropriate to talk like that. Or, could we change the subject, please?
Okay, thanks. Mr. Socrates, I don't think it's appropriate to talk like that. Could we change the subject, please?
Oh, sorry, have I said too much? Maybe we could talk about you. I like you, Anna. You're keen, but you've got a lot to learn. And I think you should wear more black. It makes you look, thinner.
He's out of order. I think he's saying too much. Ask him to keep the conversation professional.
Right. Good idea. Mr. Socrates, thank you. But can we keep our conversation professional? There's a lot to discuss about our European market strategy.
Yeah, right. Absolutely right. Anyway, You're going to have to lead this one, not that Tom guy. I'm thinking of firing him. His results ain't that great, and...
Sorry to interrupt. I just wondered if you'd like some nuts.
Hey, Tom. I was just saying to Anna, your results haven't been that good, and I'm thinking of...
Of having another drink. Thinking of having another drink. Mrs. Socrates, did you know Tom actually has a great idea for selling laser-curved oranges to Spain?
Do I?
That's good to hear, Tom. Email them to me and I'll check them over tomorrow.
Of course you will, Mrs. Socrates. Now, how would you like to drink something? Less strong? Orange juice, perhaps?
Nah. I think I'll try some more of the English beer.
I think Anna's just done Tom a big favour. She stopped him getting fired, for now. Sometimes conversations with your boss can get too personal, but I think Anna's got the hang of keeping things professional. Here's a reminder of what she said.
It's not appropriate to talk like that. Could we change the subject, please? Can we keep our conversation professional, please?
So Anna seems to be Mr. Socrates' favourite team member. But now she's got some explaining to do to Tom.
Anna, what were you talking about to Mr. Socrates? Ideas for selling laser-curved oranges to Spain.
He was going to fire you. So I was trying to tell him you had great ideas.
What? You helped me? Oh, Anna, I don't know what to say.
Yes?
I need to go back to the office to work on some ideas.
Good idea. Keep it professional, eh, Tom? Until next time, bye! Bye-bye, Mr. Socrates! He's flying back to America, leaving Tip Top Trading's London team trying to work out how best to focus their business on the European market.
Sorry to keep you waiting. I had to go to the airport with Mr. Socrates to see him off. We had a good chat in the taxi and he said some very positive things.
Oh, yes. Like what?
Well, how nice English beer is.
Yeah, but... what about the European marketing strategy? What are we going to do about that?
Well, Anna is supposed to lead on that. I'm taking a more biscuitorial control over it.
A what?
It means that you do all the work while he eats all the biscuits.
Do you mind, Tom? Now, what I'm thinking is we put the feelers out, do some cold calling, see what people are buying at the moment.
Cold calling? But I like to be warm when I'm on the phone.
No, Anna. Cold calling is when you call prospective clients when they're not expecting you to ask them something or to sell them something. I'm very good at calling people.
Yeah, usually the hairdresser. So, Paul, where do we begin? Who do we call first?
Track down some potential clients in Europe, see what they're buying now, see what they want in the future. Make them think it's our laser-curved fruit that they want.
But keep your calls brief. International calls are very expensive.
OK, Anna, it's time to cold call. What are you going to say?
I don't know.
Find someone to call, then be pleasant and polite. When you call, ask to speak to the person who deals with buying or purchasing. And then ask that person if they could spare a few minutes of their time.
Okay, here goes. Let's have a look. Fruit growers, fruit pickers, fruit traders, Fruit Traders International. 00439 845544.
Bonjour.
Don't be surprised. You've called a company in France. They speak French. Just ask if it's okay to speak English.
Oh, hello. Is it possible to speak to you in English?
Oui, yes.
Great. Are you the person who purchases plastic fruits for your company?
I am. How can I help you?
Yes. Can you spare a few minutes of your time? I want to sell you some laser-curved fruit.
What?
That's a bit direct, Anna. Slow down and tell them your name and why you're calling. Find out something about them. Maybe say, I'd like to tell you about our great new laser-curved fruit. Ask them, how much plastic fruit do you buy? And at the end of the call, say, thank you for your time. We hope to hear from you soon. Give it a go, Anna.
Okay. Hello, my name is Anna. How are you today?
Good, thank you.
That's good. I'd like to tell you about our great new laser-curved fruit.
Oh, yes?
Our company is called Tip Top Trading, and we are the UK's number one plastic fruit manufacturer. And, well, we're so proud of our fruit that we've decided to let the rest of Europe enjoy too.
Very good, Anna.
We make our fruit using laser-curved technology. In fact, we've just launched our best product ever, the Imperial Lemon. It looks so real you want to squeeze it.
Lemon. Interesting.
Anna's got the hang of this. She's on fire! I mean, she's doing really well. Her cold calling technique has really warmed up. She's pitched the product. Now she needs to sell.
So, thank you for your time. I hope you may consider us when you next purchase some plastic fruit.
We will certainly consider your company.
Well, we hope to hear from you soon. Goodbye. Tom, how are you getting on?
Well, if that's what you think, you can shove your kumquats. Hello?
Oh. What's wrong?
They've hung up on me. Really? He said the plastic fruit industry is in meltdown. Oh, Anna, if I don't get any contracts soon, I'll be fired.
Well, this calls for teamwork, Tom. Tomorrow, Tuesday, we're going to tackle this task together.
Hooray for Anna! Now she's sounding like a leader. And she's mastered cold calling by using some simple phrases like these.
My name is Anna. Can you spare a few minutes of your time? I'd like to tell you about our great new laser-curved fruit. How much plastic fruit do you buy? Thank you for your time. We hope to hear from you soon.
Anna, there's a call for you from someone in France. They want to talk to you about lemons.
Sounds promising. Find out what happens next time on English at Work. Bye.
Yes, we have plenty in stock. They're £4 per unit. They are good quality ones.
The company in France that Anna called earlier has called her back. Let's hope they're making an order.
Laser technology isn't cheap. I see. Well, thanks for calling back. Bye.
Everything okay, Anna?
Not really. One of the companies I called has rung back.
Good.
But they don't want to place an order. They say we're too expensive.
So you let them go? Didn't you negotiate with them?
Oh, was I meant to? I wasn't sure what to say.
Having trouble, Anna? Don't worry, I'm sure that I can help. Negotiating is my thing.
Negotiating is my thing? What is he like? Mind you, he has won a Pear Salesman of the Year award, so he must be doing something right.
Are you sure, Tom? Don't you want to negotiate your own deals?
I owe you one, Anna, after you saved my bacon with Mr. Socrates the other night. And besides, you and me...
Come on, you two. Get a move on. Europe is waiting for us. Custard cream, anyone?
No, thanks. Right. You need to call that French company back and ask them what kind of price they're willing to pay.
And then say, that's fine?
No! Negotiate. Say, I don't think we can go that low.
I don't think we can go that low.
If they want a bigger discount, tell them they will have to buy more stock.
More stock, bigger discount.
Yeah. And if you still can't agree a price, tell them I'll meet you halfway.
Meet halfway? That means going to Paris.
No, halfway on the price. That line always works for me. I sold a load of plastic pears that way once.
So that's I'll meet you halfway. Thanks, Tom. I'm really impressed.
Am I? Really?
What? I was going to say, you really do know your stuff, despite what other people say.
What?
Right. I'm off to make that call right now.
Good luck, Anna, and well done, Tom. Nice to hear him give some useful advice, but will it work? Let's remind ourselves of the phrases he suggested Anna uses when negotiating a sale.
What kind of price are you willing to pay? I don't think we can go that low. If you buy more stock, I can offer you a bigger discount. I'll meet you halfway.
Let's see how Anna has got on.
Success! They've agreed to buy 5,000 imperial lemons.
Ah, brilliant! I knew you would be great. Did those killer lines of mine work?
Sort of. But when I said what price were they looking to pay, they said the full price. As long as I send them the contract today, so I'd better go and get an envelope and post it as soon as I can.
Oh, great.
Tom, can you come over here to the stationery cupboard and get an envelope from the top shelf for me?
Yeah, I suppose so. I'm coming. Oh!
Oh, Tom! Why did you do that? It won't open! It's locked! Help! Help!
Help!
Uh-oh. Help. This should be interesting. Help. How are they going to explain being locked in the stationery cupboard?
Let us out.
Until next time, bye!
Let us out! We're stuck!